Good morning.
Good morning, Jayant. How are you doing, Jayant?
Sir, I'm doing very fine. Thank you, sir.
Jayant, have you got yourself vaccinated?
Yes, sir. I have got myself vaccinated.
Which dose of vaccine, Jayant, you took?
Sir, Covishield.
Covishield.
Yes.
Jayant, what is the difference between Covishield and Covaxin in terms of chemical composition?
Yes, sir. Sir, in Covishield, they are using an inactivated adenovirus. So this adenovirus is found in the chimpanzees. And through this, they are initiating an immunity or a response in our body. Because this adenovirus is similar to the coronavirus in its structure. So that is there in Covishield. Sir, however, in Covaxin, they are using an inactivated virus of the coronavirus itself. In that, they are not using the adenovirus. So that is the difference.
Okay. Jayant, without making any direct or indirect, explicit or implicit references to your religion, caste, or gender, introduce yourself to the panel in terms of values and virtues that you hold very dear, and you are not going to sacrifice them under any given circumstances. Yes, go on.
A very warm good morning to all the panel members. I am Jayant. So I like to meet new people, learn from their experiences. So this through this, I kind of learn from their experiences, and I can tend to imply in my real life as well. So some of the values that I hold is the positivity and an optimism towards the life. The second one would be having an integral set of values and do not compromising even at the case or even in any circumstances as well. Thirdly, whenever I am indulging in any kind of activity, I try to give my full potential in it so that I can take out the maximum results out of it. So these are some of the value sets that are in me.
Jayant, if you have to choose between integrity and justice, what will you choose and why?
Sir, in my opinion, if we see the overall definition of the integrity. So it is defined as having the highest moral virtues in itself. So if there is any situation where there is a compromise on the case of justice as well, then it, in my opinion, it won't be in the definition of integrity. And the definition of integrity is such a wholesome concept that it involves justice in it itself. So sir, if I am explicitly choosing integrity, then the justice would be implicitly measured in it, sir.
Okay. Jayant, you celebrate your birthday on 7th of November.
Yes, sir.
Right? A very important personality also celebrates his or her birthday on that date. Do you have any idea whom I am talking about?
Sorry, sir, I am not aware of it.
Have you heard about Madame Curie?
Yes, sir, I have heard of it.
You share your birthday, Jayant, with her. Do you know what is her greatest contribution?
Yes, sir. Sir, she won a Nobel Prize in sir chemistry. So due to her contribution, especially to the radioactive materials. So she did her research in the radioactivity in the early 20th century. So sir, that was her contribution. And ultimately, sir, it also led to the nuclear technologies we have today.
So Madame Curie has also contributed to cancer research. Do you have any idea about it?
Sorry, sir, I am not exactly aware of the research, sir. However, sir, the reason for her death was related to the prolonged exposure to the radioactive material, which ultimately led to cancer in her body, sir. So, sir, that was the reason for her death, sir. So, sir.
Have you heard about radiotherapy? Radiotherapy,
yes,
chemotherapy, have you heard about these terms?
Yes, sir. I have heard about it.
Okay. Jayant, are you also aware that 7th of November is celebrated all across India as a very important day?
Sorry, sir. I'm not aware of it.
It is also celebrated as National Cancer Awareness Day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that.
Jayant, I was going through your DAF, and let me tell you, it is really interesting to note one thing, that your hobby is to watch documentaries on World War II.
Yes, sir.
Which was the latest documentary that you have watched regarding World War II?
Yes, sir. So the latest one was on the Netflix, that is by the name of World War II in Color. So, sir, it had 8 episodes on it, kind of shows the World War II real footages in a colorful manner.
Hmm. Okay, so what was the theme of the last episode?
Yes, sir. So the theme of the last episode was the surrender of Germany and Japan, sir. So, sir, they were showing the early months of the 1945. When the army of USSR and the allied armies, they were capturing the Germans on the both fronts. And sir, it also showed the use of nuclear bomb by the USA on Japan, specifically on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, that led to the ultimate surrender of the Japanese armies.
Why, Jayant, Hiroshima was chosen as the target for dropping the bombs? Why only Hiroshima and Nagasaki? Not any other city like Tokyo or Nagoya or any other city, Kyoto. Why only Hiroshima and Nagasaki?
Yes, sir. Sir, there were several reasons for it. So, for example, the Hiroshima, it was a very strategic city, if we see on the geography. And it has also all the factories that were providing all the ammunition to the Japanese army. So, sir, there were two objectives for it. So USA first thought that they would destroy all the factories that were providing all the arms and ammunition, especially to the Japanese army. So first was that reason, sir. Secondly, sir, that the cities like Tokyo and Nagoya, they were deep inside the Japanese mainland as compared to the cities like Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and they were heavily guarded as well. So USA was also not sure if their first strike would be successful or not. So that's why, sir, they chose Hiroshima as their first target.
Jayant, where the devastation was more, Hiroshima or Nagasaki?
Sir, it was more in Nagasaki, sir.
Are you sure about it, Jayant?
Sir, if we see by the casualty wise, sir, I have read that there were 50,000 more deaths in Nagasaki as compared to the Hiroshima. Sir, on that aspect, it was more.
Devastation is not only related to deaths, but also the after effects?
Yes, sir.
After dropping the bombs?
Yes,
okay, anyhow. What moral lessons have you learned from World War II? Give me 3 lessons that you have learned from World War II. Moral lessons.
Yes. Sir, the primary lesson would be the importance of human life and humanity. Sir, if we see, around 70 million people perished in World War II. And there was a large scale, eventually there was a full-scale destruction of the Europe. So that is the importance of human life, sir, and peace in the world. So that was the one moral lesson. Sir, second moral lesson that I got, that the sometimes greed so much overrides the personality of a person that it overcomes all the national interests. If we see, if we can see from the example of Hitler as well. So that was the second moral lesson. So third was the again the importance of non-violence, because there was large mass-scale crimes against the Jews, especially the Holocaust, in which around 6 million Jews died. So that also showed the tendency of humans to discriminate humans, especially on the basis of race and the religion. So, sir, that was the third moral lesson.
Okay. You have also played tennis.
Yes.
And going by the information that you have provided, it seems that you are really good at it. Are you good at it?
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay. You have played tennis at the state levels as well.
Yes.
Am I right, Jayant?
Yes.
Jayant, you know that there are 4 major grand slams in tennis?
Yes, sir. Right.
And what are they?
So the first one is Australian Open. The second one is French Open, which is currently being played on. The third one is Wimbledon. And the last one is US Open.
Which is the oldest of all 4?
Sir, Wimbledon is the oldest.
Oldest. And then, which is the youngest?
Sir, youngest is Australian Open.
Okay. Now, you know that Wimbledon is played on grass court.
Yes.
Whereas the term Roland Garros is used for French Open.
Yes.
Because it's clay court. What about the Australian Open and American Open courts? How are they different from each other?
Sir, the So both of these courts, like Australian Open and US Open, they are played on the hard court. However, the slight difference is with the respect of the material that we use. So since both of these courts are synthetic courts, those are the differences on the basis of the material that has been applied on the court, sir. I'm not exactly aware of which material. However, sir, they both comes under the category of the hard courts.
Have you heard about the term DecoTurf?
Yes, sir, I have heard about
DecoTurf. It is with respect to which hard court? Australian Open hard court or the US Open?
Sorry, sir, I'm not exactly sure of it.
Okay. Now, Jayant.
Yes.
The color of the ball that is used in tennis is yellow or yellowish?
Yes.
Why yellow has been chosen and not any other color?
So it can be due to the visibility of the ball when we are playing the tennis on various courts. So it can be attached to the gameplay. So suppose two players are playing, then on a yellow ball, it would be much more visible because it has a slight contrast to the surrounding color as well. So players would find it much easier to play on that ball.
Okay, when the game started initially, what was the color of the ball? Was it yellow back then as well?
Sorry, sir, I'm not exactly aware of it.
Initially, the color of the ball was white. And yes, rightly you have pointed it out that due to visibility factor, when we look at it in television screens, the color was recommended to yellow. Anyhow.
Thank you, sir, for that.
Jayant.
Yes.
What is the difference between the terms career grand slam and grand slam?
Yes, sir. Sir, in career grand slam, so suppose a player is winning all the grand slams. So there are these four grand slams which are called. So if he wins all the grand slam, then it is called the career grand slam. And if it is winning one of the grand slam or two of the, not winning all of them, then it generally referred to as the grand slam.
Grand slam. Yes. What about a person who wins all the four grand slams in one year, one calendar year? What is he then called?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So that is called the career grand slam, sir.
That is career grand slam.
Sir, I'm not exactly aware, but recently I read that Djokovic is one of the newest player who won all the four Grand Slam in a year. So, sir, that's how I recall it.
Who's your favorite badminton tennis player?
Sir, Roger. Tennis.
Roger Federer.
Yes.
Name one quality in Roger Federer that you like.
Sir, the attitude of never giving up, even at the age of 39, he is still among the top 10 players in the world and is still competing very hard. And even after going through various surgeries and various challenges in his life as well, he's still playing. So that is one quality that I especially like about him, sir.
And one thing in Roger Federer's personality, which you do not approve. Name one thing in Roger Federer's personality that you do not approve.
So I like to think for it for some time.
Yes.
Sir, sometimes, like recently, if we see from the example of French Open, even after winning the third round and he was in the fourth round, he opted out of the tournament because he stated that his priorities were more at Wimbledon. So, sir, that was one attitude because, sir, he was playing very good in the tournament and he suddenly withdrew it because he saw that he would like to focus more on Wimbledon. So, that was one attitude, sir, I didn't specifically like, sir.
Okay. Jayant, one last question before I pass the baton to sir.
Yes.
Your optional is anthropology.
Yes.
Have you heard about Franz Boas?
Yes, sir, I have heard about
Boas. And have you heard about Ruth Benedict?
Yes.
What is the major difference between the ideas of Boas and Benedict? Tell in one line, major difference in their ideas.
Sir, Ruth Benedict gave the theory of the personality, how it affects the culture of a particular environment. So, sir, that was one difference, sir. However, sir, Franz Boas, he was more on a cultural relativist. who thought that overall the culture has a more on a influence on the personality of an individual.
Jayant?
Yes.
Societies are different.
Yes.
And similar. What do you understand by this statement?
Sir, societies are different with respect to different traditions. For example, the society of India would be different from the society of the US. With the case of individualism very high in US, well, we have more of a phenomenon of joint families, the that bond of families in India. However, sir, they are similar in that aspect that there are some various uniform principles that are very much uniform across all the society that is very essential for the survival of any species. So, sir, that is similar if we see. So, sir, the use of fire or the use of technology, it is similar in various societies. However, with respect to traditions and cultures, sir, there are differences.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Jayant, can you hear me?
Yes. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Jayant. Jayant, you just heard that you celebrate your birthday on the 7th of November.
Yes.
And your hobby is traveling.
Yes, sir.
Any important person that you remember about who shares his birthday with you, who shares the same, I won't call it a hobby, but the same profession?
Sir, from traveling?
Traveling, yes.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
Okay, you have heard of the name of James Cook or not?
No, sir, I have not heard of his name.
Okay. You said your hobby is playing tennis and you represented your state also in this. At which level did you play for your state?
Sir, so there were the district tournament. So every school was participating in the tournament. So, sir, I won that district tournament and then we were selected for the state level championship in order to represent our district. So, sir, on the state level, sir, I played, sir, where sir, different districts of Rajasthan were competing.
Okay. Tell me, now that you have attained a good level in tennis, tell me, what is the height of the tennis net?
Yes, sir. Sir, so the height, the average height of the tennis net, sir, it is around 2.5 feet, sir.
2.5 feet, are you sure?
Sir, I'm not exactly sure of the exact height, but sir, it is in the range of 2.5 to sir, 3 feet, sir.
Sorry? Come again, please.
Sir, I'm not exactly aware of the exact height. However, sir, it is in the range of 2.5 to 3 feet, sir. Because, sir, when I used to play, sir, I used to compare it with my height. So, my height is 6 feet. So, generally, the net was around my leg, sir. So, sir, that's how I reduced it.
Okay. I think your legs are longer than what you probably feel they are. The height of the net is 3 feet, 6 inches. Okay.
Thank you.
Nevertheless, you know, and you talked about Grand Slam.
Yes.
After Grand Slam, there are different level of tournaments. You must have heard of, you know, World Tour Masters 1,500, 250.
Yes.
What are they?
So, sir, apart from Grand Slam, these are various tournaments that are conducted by ATP. So, the number that is attached to it, for example, ATP 1,000. So, sir, it is considered the highest level of tournament just after the Grand Slam. And sir, the hierarchy is like ATP 500 is below it and the lowest is the ATP 250. And due to this hierarchy, there is also the difference of points which one gets by winning the tournament. So that is the hierarchy that is used in this tennis tournament.
How many points are given for each of these tournaments?
Sorry, sir, I'm not exactly aware of the points.
Okay. You said Federer is one of your most favorite tennis players.
Yes.
Right? Now, tell me, Federer shares a very unique record in the field of tennis.
Yes.
What is that?
Sir, recently, sir, he is the only player or the player with the highest number of Grand Slams. So he has won 20 Grand Slam and is highest in the men's categories.
Are you sure he is the only player or anybody else who shares the same number of tournament wins?
Sir, in men's category, sir, he is the only player who also with the highest number of Grand Slams, sir.
What about Nadal?
Sir, Nadal is at 19, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir, I'm sure.
Okay. And Djokovic?
Sir, 18, sir.
Okay. You talked in terms of the Hiroshima and of the Second World War, one of your favorite areas of interest.
Yes.
Now, tell me, you said the bombs were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki by choice.
Yes.
Are you sure that the bomb on Nagasaki was dropped by choice and not by chance? Was it the planned target or was the target somewhere else?
Sir, I'm not exactly sure that was it a choice or chance. Sir, as by my limited knowledge, sir, what I read was that after Nagasaki, sir, they were planning to drop a bomb on Tokyo. So the Nagasaki was used as a showcase to the Japanese army that how big the destruction can be. And their next target was at Tokyo, sir. However, sir, I'm not exactly aware of that was it by chance or a choice.
Okay. Tell me, what was the biggest highlight of the Second World War?
Sir, the biggest highlight was that the center of power that shifted from London to Washington and Moscow, sir. So it led to the change in the world order specifically. So there was a shift of power from Great Britain, France to the USA and USSR.
Okay, strategically and tactically?
Sir, technologically, the shift of the use of the nuclear technology. So it led to a proliferation, especially there was a weapons race between especially the USA and USSR, which ultimately led to the Cold War as well. And sir, secondly, sir, the V2 rockets that were used by the Nazi Germany, and the chief scientist was Paul von Braun. So he was later inducted in NASA by the USA. And it ultimately led to the moon landing that was there in 1969 by the Apollo mission. So, sir, that was also one tactical highlight of the World War II as well.
Anything about the air power?
Yes, sir. Sir, USA proved to be a major air superiority, especially, sir, if we see from the case of Europe. So, the B-29 bombers, they were at a highly much advantageous position as compared to the bombers that were used by the Germany as well and also the USSR. So from that aspect also, and also the USA become one of the largest country with the largest bombers at that time, especially when the World War II was at peak in 1945. When it was ending, it was the largest manufacturer of the bombers and also the airplanes, the fighter airplanes. So sir, that was also one aspect.
Okay, these two bombs that were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, what were the names of these, what are the names given to these bombs?
Yes, sir. Sir, the one was named as Fat Boy, and sir, other one was, sir, I'm not exactly sure, sir, Little Boy or something, sir, I'm not exactly sure. But, sir, one was Fat Boy.
One is Little Boy and second is Fat Boy.
Sir, I'm not sure of the Little Boy, sir, but one was Fat Boy, sir.
Are you sure the name was Fat Boy?
No, sir, I am not exactly sure.
Little Boy and Fat Man. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
You talked about the aircraft that were used. Which were the aircraft used to drop these two bombs?
Sir, I am not exactly sure of the aircraft, sir. However, sir, as per my limited knowledge, sir, they were, sir, B-29 bombers. Because, sir, they had the longest flight distance that which they can cover, sir. So
they were the B-29. What were they actually known as? What were they famously known as?
Sorry, sir, I was not able to hear the question.
What were the other name given to the B-29 bombers?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
They were called the Super Fortresses. Okay. One last question. Again, I would like to talk about the World War II, something which interests me a lot. Tell me, the term, I don't know if you've heard the term, Dibakusha. What does this term mean in terms of the nuclear attack on Hiroshima and Nagasaki?
Sir, can you repeat the term, sir? I was not able to hear it.
Dibakusha. Have you heard of this word, Hibakusha?
Sir, I've heard of it, sir, but I'm not able to recall it, sir, right now. Sir,
okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, Jayant.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Jayant, your correspondence address mentions Bikaner, right?
Yes. Yes.
So, can you please highlight how Bikaner got formed?
Yes, sir. Sir, the foundations were laid in the late 15th century when the Rao Bika of the Jodhpur dynasty, he came to the Bikaner and established the city of Bikaner and the present kingdom of Bikaner. And sir, then afterwards, sir, it became one of the prominent princely states under the British Empire as well. And sir, the major sea or the modern architect of Bikaner is attributed to Maharaja Ganga Singh. That ruled in the earlier 20th century as well. And he constructed various infrastructural projects, especially in the region, that was Ganges Canal. And the initial blueprint of Indira Gandhi Canal was also laid during his tenure only. And various railway lines and the Lalgarh railway station that is very famous in the in our country for the, especially for the manufacturing of various coaches, for the servicing of various coaches. So that was also laid in the Bikaner.
Okay. Good. Jayant, highlight some three major crops of Churu district.
Yes, sir. Sir, the prominent one is the, sir, Bajra, that is highly prominent in the Churu district. Sir, the second, sir, I am, sir, not exactly aware of the English name, sir, but Mote is one that is highly sown in the Churu district. And sir, some of the areas that have well laid irrigation practices, they also sow, sir, gehum, that is wheat, and mustard, sir, that is sarso, sir.
Okay. Churu district specifically belongs to extreme climatic zone. It has very high temperature in summers and very low temperature in winter.
Yes.
What irrigation practices or what agricultural practices, to be specific, you propose in such climatic conditions?
Sir, especially if we see, sir, in summer, there is a huge scarcity of water in the Churu district all over the place because the temperature sometimes goes above 50 degrees Celsius. Sir, in that aspect, sir, we have limited irrigation facilities. However, sir, we can use the technology that was used in the traditional times or the traditional sources of water. Sir, they used to store water in various ponds, various step wells, is that. So, sir, that needs to be encouraged because that has been lost somehow in the urban areas and also the rural areas as well. Sir, secondly, there can be high use of drip irrigation because since the area is highly deficient of water, so since Israel is successfully doing it, so some of the technologies can be emulated in the Churu as well in order to ensure that there is effectiveness as well and also the productivity in the regions.
And what about winter?
Yes, sir. Sir, in winter, sir, again, sir, if we can use, because in winter, sir, we don't have the monsoon. So again, sir, we face this issue of water scarcity. And there has been times the protest or there has been complaints by the farmer that there has been frostbite, especially among the crops, that has led to the destruction. Sir, there is this technology where they use the polythene covers, especially over the crops in order to ensure that the fog and the frost does not reach these crops. Sir, that can be employed especially in those areas. And secondly, sir, again, sir, the drip irrigation is a universal method that can be highly employed.
Okay, Jayant. Good. Jayant, you were the winner of Intra-College Entrepreneurship Competition 2018, right?
Yes.
Okay. So you must be aware about the nitty-gritties of business. You must be aware that in business, the major chunk of value addition is cornered by entrepreneur.
Yes.
What do you think about it? Is it correct morally?
So I won't say that it is cornered by the entrepreneurs. If we see the present examples of the various startups or unicorns in our country, so sir, for example, sir, in the Amazon also, sir, only 12% of the holding is holded by the Jeff Bezos, sir. The other 88% is holded by various private companies as well. So sir, I won't say that it is cornered by the entrepreneurs. However, sir, it is true that when the startup is in its initial phase, especially the CEO or the founders of the startup, sir, they have huge holdings, especially in the startup. And it is certainly, sir, due to the idea that they have given
Jayant,
the idea.
Jayant, let me rephrase the question for you. Yes. Instead of entrepreneur, use the word owner. The major chunk of value addition is cornered by owners of an enterprise. Is it correct?
Sir, it is due to the fact, yes, sir, it is correct, sir, in some way. Sir, it is due to the fact, sir, that the initial investment, sir, the shareholding in a particular enterprise or the stock of the particular enterprise, it is determined by the initial investment that is done by a particular person. Sir, when a startup, or a business, when it is in the nascent phase, so a person that is giving the highest amount of investment would ultimately get the highest amount of share as well. So, sir, that is due to the fact that they have the huge amount of ownership. However, sir, it is also true that they also help in the value addition of the team because they also provide a kind of leadership that is also needed. And all the big companies that we see today, from SpaceX that is led by the Elon Musk, from the Amazon to Facebook, it is also due to the kind of leadership that they provide. And sir, sir, that is due to the
but don't you don't you don't you think the labor class of an enterprise who gives their sweat to the enterprise, to the business, they work the most for the business, but still they get lesser and lesser share as the time passes. According to the recent report of International Labor Organization, around 20 years back, labor used to get 40% of value addition of an enterprise. But currently, the scenario is that they are getting only 15%.
Yes, sir. Sir, that is an issue, sir, because, sir, currently, sir, the method the company is involves is, so they give a salary, a fixed salary to the laborers as well. And apart from that, they also provide a kind of shares of the companies as well. Sir, however, sir, you are right that it is highly concentrated in few hands, and there should be some revisiting to this model as well.
Okay, Jayant, you love watching World War II documentaries.
Yes.
Are you aware of American campaign known as island hopping?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall it right now. Sir, I have heard about this term.
Okay. What was the role of Manhattan Project in World War II?
Yes, sir. Sir, the role of Manhattan Project was very immense, and eventually it became a determinant of the US victory in World War II. The role of Manhattan Project, it ultimately led to the construction of the nuclear bomb that was there, and all the major scientists, they ultimately resulted in making a nuclear bomb that proved to be a detrimental factor, especially that end the World War II as well. So I would say, sir, that was a huge.
Let us say India also is a nuclear power, and yes, India is at war with any one country, and you are in charge of bombing, and you receive an order from your high command that you have to throw a nuclear bomb on a particular city which is densely populated.
Yes.
What would be your call? Will you drop the bomb or you'll decline to obey the orders? Because as you are aware that the city is densely populated.
Sir, I would take into account the certain kind of factors. Firstly, sir, presently India follows a no first use policy. So it will only use the nuclear bomb if it is being struck by a nuclear bomb by the other country. And sir, secondly,
question was that you have received the order.
Yes.
From your high command. That means that first use policy is no longer valid.
Okay, sir.
Jayant, my question was that as you received the order from your high command, no yes. valid, then yes. what will be your take?
Sir, I'm assuming that if I'm taking, if I am get the orders from the high command, then it would be a grave security concern in our country. And that's why they have taken this decision. So, sir, I would go with the orders that I have received from the high command because it is a question of national security as well and also a case of self-defense. So secondly, sir, if it is if the population is densely populated, then the use of nuclear bomb can be used in certain aspects. So rather than just dropping it on the ground, the bomb can be detonated above some height, around 500 meters or 1 kilometer, in order to ensure that there is minimum destruction to the and the loss of life as well. So that is one aspect that can be sir, taken into account.
Okay. One last question from my side, Jayant. You studied at BITS Pilani.
Yes.
Right? What was the or what is the primary motive of BITS Pilani? The slogan which they use.
Sir, this, the English translation, sir, is it is innovate, achieve and lead, sir. Roberts.
Okay. And any specific primary motive? Other apart from the slogan,
sir, the sir, what I have gathered from this that innovate, achieve, lead is to have a mindset of innovation in order to solve the unique problems that are present in the society as well and also in the world as a whole, in order to ensure that you achieve your specific targets by innovating and you lead in the world from the front in order to ensure that you have contributed especially to the nation's development. So that, sir, I have incurred from the motto.
Okay.
Thanks.
Jayant, you were just talking about the Mughal Empire and history around Bikaner.
Yes.
Now, have you heard about Aurangzeb, the famous Mughal emperor?
Yes, sir, I have heard about
him. How would you like to define him? A hero or a destructor?
Sir, I won't define him as hero for sure, sir, because, sir, if we compare him with the other Mughal emperors, so let's compare him with the Akbar, sir. Sir, especially, sir, the policies of the Aurangzeb, his the policy of Deccan as well was not a major success because it resulted in long rebellions, especially by the Mughal Maratha Empire as well. Secondly, sir, the long-drawn friendship that Akbar had with all the neighboring empires like the Rajputana, the Rajput kingdoms as well. Aurangzeb had a strained relationship with the Rajputs as well. And that ultimately, sir, resulted in the dissolution of the Mughal Empire after the death of the Aurangzeb. Yes, we can say that under his empire, the extent of the empire was the largest because it stretched toward the South India as well. However, sir, he was not able to have a socially cohesive society in the sense that various religious policies of the Akbar, Aurangzeb as well, especially the imposition of the jizya tax. Sir, it led to the factionalism inside the country as well because various Sikh empires, the Jat rulers, the Rajputs and the Marathas in the south or the Deccan. Sir, it resulted in the dissolution of the Mughal Empire afterwards his death. So, sir, that is the conclusion, sir, that I gather.
Okay, Jayant, going by your explanation,
yes.
Aurangzeb is hero by no means. If that is the case, then why are we not changing the names of the places which are named Aurangabad? There are two or three of them all across India. Should we change their names immediately? If he is not a hero, why are we celebrating his name?
Sir, there can be certain factors that can be attached while changing a name. So, sir, firstly, sir, changing a name requires huge amount of administrative practices and a lot amount of cost because, sir, we would be changing the seals, we would be changing all the boards. So that would be a mammoth administrative exercise. So that is one issue. Secondly, sir, there should be a popular demand from the society as well in order to ensure that the name should be changed. So, sir, taking these two factors into account, then a decision should be taken, sir.
What about the moral stance? Should morality be outweighed by administrative efficiency or cost factors?
Sir, I would say that we need to maintain a balance between the both, because we are a country that is aspiring to become a good or world economic power as well. So we should also take decisions that are based, that are on the basis of rationality and objectivity as well, and rather than solely on a basis of the cultural practices. So I think that a balance between the both can be maintained.
Good. Jayant, suppose you are a judge.
Yes.
Who is about to adjudicate two matters. Both of them are of highest priority. And you have time to address only one among them. You cannot address both of them today.
Yes.
But you have to choose between them. The first case relates to a child who was being forced to work in a hazardous sector. He has been rescued.
Yes.
And he has faced all forms of atrocities that you can imagine. The second is the case of a young adolescent girl who was trafficked across the borders and has been rescued by an NGO. If you have to give priority between these two cases, which it would be, and on what ground you are making that decision?
Sir, I think that both the cases are very sensitive, and I would be more than honored to give a judgment on both and decide on the matters of both. However, sir, if given a chance, sir, I would choose the second case because it involves a lot of international affairs as well. Since the country, since the girl has been recovered or she has been taken from the surrounding countries as well. So, sir, there would be wide repercussion in the international community as well. And it is also a very sensitive matter as far as India's foreign policy is concerned. So, sir, that would be a very sensitive case. As far as the child is concerned, sir, we have various acts under the various statutes. And, sir, that can be taken off by the other judges as well. Sir, if given a chance, I would choose the second judgment.
Okay. Jayant, who is your favorite political leader who is presently active in politics?
Sir, the current Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, sir. He is my favorite political leader.
What are the attributes in his personality that you like? Name three of them. Three attributes in his personality which you like.
Yes, sir. Sir, the first one would be the lead from front. Mm. Whenever the country needs him, or whenever there is a situation of grave concern, then he comes on TV and he leads from the front. So, sir, that builds up certain kind of confidence and the motivation among the whole country. Secondly, sir, the ability to take bold decisions. If you see from the example of GST, the codification of the labor laws, and even the Article 370, the amendment to the Article 370 as well. So, sir, these bold these bold reforms would eventually lead to the nation development. So, sir, secondly, that is there, sir. Sir, thirdly, sir, having a proper monitoring as well as the evaluation system. So he is, I have seen from various things that he is directly in touch with all the ministries and taking into account. So there was this one initiative by the government, that is Pragati platform, has been launched by the government, in which the Prime Minister Modi ji, he himself takes into account the various projects that have been done in the country. So, sir, that results in the faster implementation of the projects as well. So third ones or any of the things that I have regret of today, because the person I am today is due to the experiences that I had, especially in the past. And even if there were some mistakes that were done by me, I eventually learned from that mistakes and always learned that I should not repeat them in the future. Won't say mistake, but there was an, especially from my side, that I didn't take too care of my health, especially during my third year of my college. So I didn't focus much on the diet aspect, and that eventually led to poor health in myself. And sir, then I learned the importance of health, and sir, then I again got involved in the sports as well. So that is one thing, all the mistakes that I have learned.
Okay, Jayant, one final question from my side.
Yes, sir.
Jayant, if you have to define your personality through a quotation or a slogan,
yes,
what it would be? And you can frame the slogan for yourself. not necessarily that it has to be a slogan given by someone.
Yes, sir. As my name suggests, sir, the meaning of my name is Jayant, one who wins till the end, and he who always keeps on fighting. So, sir, there is this famous poem by Shri Harivansh Rai Bachchan, "Koshish karne walon ki kabhi haar nahi hoti." So, sir, there is one as phrase that I especially like, that सिंधु में डुबकी गोताखोर लगाता है, थक हार के घर लौट आता है, यूं ही नहीं मिलते मोती सहज ही गहरे पानी में, लेकिन उसकी मुट्ठी हर बार खाली नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती. सो सर दैट इज वन फ्रेज दैट आई अटैच विद माय सेल्फ.
गुड, थैंक यू जयंत.
थैंक यू सर.
ओके जयंत.
यस सर.
जयंत, दैट वाज अ गुड पोएम दैट यू सेड टॉक्ड अबाउट. You also happen to be the secretary, coordinator of your Hindi Press Club.
Yes.
What exactly were your roles and responsibilities, and what were the best learnings in that particular appointment that you held?
Sir, I was the joint coordinator of Hindi Press Club. So this, there is a technical fest named by the Apogee that is conducted every year in our college. So what we used to do was we used to print newsletters, and in those newsletter we used to mention all the events that would be happening in our college in the span of 4 and 5 days, and we also used to print all the interviews by all various personalities in our college, like director, vice chancellor, and all the sponsors. So sir, I was leading a team of around 30 people, and our major responsibility was to print those newsletters. And
okay, supposing if I have to ask you, which is your most famous muhavra in Hindi and why?
So I like to think about it, sir. Sir, the one muhavra that I am recalling right now, sir, it would be, sir, with respect to the French Open match yesterday. So Djokovic defeated Nadal, and in French Open, and Nadal is called the king of clay court. So the muhavra that I recall is, he gave "Aint ka jawab patthar se." So that is one muhavra that I am recalling, sir.
Okay, you said he beat Nadal yesterday. Now yes, you sir. Also said Nadal has got 19 Grand Slams.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I asked you the question that time also. Are you sure Nadal has got 19 Grand Slams or more than that? And who's the highest Grand Slam winner in men's?
Sir, as per my limited knowledge, sir, it is the Federer, sir, who has the highest Grand Slam. And sir, this French Open tournament was the bid of Nadal to win his 20th Grand Slam. So, sir, he, in my opinion, still, sir, he has won 19 Grand Slams.
Both of them have won 20. If he had won this, he would have become the leading player with 21. Anyway, I would want to know, in Grand Slams, which player, either men or women, holds the record for the maximum Grand Slam wins?
Sir, I'm confused between Steffi Graf and Martina Navratilova, sir. I'm not exactly sure.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. In single, sir, I'm not sure, sir, but it is, sir, either Steffi Graf or Martina Navratilova.
Anyway, Steffi Graf has got 22, whereas Margaret Court has got 24. Serena Williams at 23 was heading, looking for that. Anyway.
Thank you.
What I would want to know is, you have done your BTech from Pilani, which is an extremely prestigious organization.
Yes, sir.
Why do you want then to leave this particular job and get into the civil service?
Yes, sir. Sir, it was in the third year of my college when I decided that, sir, I would be joining civil services. And sir, the seeds were sown, sir, when the district magistrate, he visited our school. And sir, those germinated when I realized that I was more inclined to civil services. because it would provide a perfect overlap of job satisfaction and also the opportunity to make long-standing or long-lasting changes at the ground level, sir. So that was my primary reason, sir, to pursue a career in civil services.
So how did the choice of anthropology come about as an optional subject?
Yes. So when I realized that my engineering discipline, manufacturing engineering, can't be taken as an optional in civil services. So, sir, I had done a course called the Contemporary India in my college year, in my second year. And in that, sir, I read about various new cultures and tribes of the Northeast India as well. And sir, then I read a book called Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari. So I somewhat got interested in all this evolution and reading about tribes. So sir, that was the primary reason, sir, why I took anthropology as an option.
Okay. If I were to ask you, you know, in the field of anthropology, it is believed that there are four fields of anthropology.
Yes.
Which are they?
Yes. Sir, the first one is sociocultural anthropology. Second is the physical anthropology. Third is archaeological anthropology. And fourth is linguistic anthropology.
Physical anthropology is also known as what? The other name given to physical anthropology?
Sir, biological anthropology.
Okay, good. Okay, tell me one thing. You are just 23 years old. What was the happiest moment in your life?
Yes, sir. Sir, I like to think for it. Yes, sir. Sir, it was, sir, when I was playing the final of district championship against my opponent, sir. And sir, all my family members and my friends were present, sir, to cheer me up. And sir, that was a very tough match because I was losing. I had lost the first set and I was very concerned about the match as well. And sir, when I came back strong and won the second and the third set and eventually the championship, sir, that was a very happiest moment because my family was very happy and my friends were very happy for me as well. So that I would state one of the happiest moments of my life.
Okay, tell me, what in your idea is the idea of happiness?
Sir, in my definition of happiness is a peace of mind and a certain kind of satisfaction that I have. And sir, I don't attach happiness to any one instance. I rather consider it as a journey rather than a destination. So even now when I'm giving this interview, I am truly happy. And also when I am traveling any kind to any kind of place, the moments that I gather, I get a certain kind of happiness as well. When I see the trees and the birds and dogs playing around, that is also happiness, sir, in my definition.
Okay, when you said you're fond of traveling yes. And you keep traveling, then why is IFS your fourth choice, not your first choice?
Yes, sir. Sir, in my opinion, sir, I would also get all the opportunities of traveling in the IAS as well and also IPS. Sir, the reason for putting IFS at my fourth preference was that I would like to give a preference while serving in our country. So that was the my preference for putting IFS at fourth.
Okay, one last question.
Yes.
What do you think is more important? Creativity or knowledge?
Sir, in my opinion, sir, both the things are important. And especially creativity and knowledge, they are very important in a person's life. Sir, however, sir, if given a chance, sir, I would especially prescribe to the knowledge. Because if one gets a knowledge of any thing, then he would certainly get creativity as well with time preference. So, sir, for example, if I get the knowledge on how to draw a particular kind of thing, then I would certainly get creativity with the passing time, sir. So, sir, that is my understanding, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Jayant.
Thank you, sir.
Jayant, are you yes. aware about the term called Industry 5.0?
Sir, I am aware of the term Industry 4.0, sir. However, sir, of 5.0, sir, I am not aware of it.
Okay. Let me give you a hint about it, that Industry 5.0 is obviously an improvement over Industry 4.0. What is Industry 4.0? And tell me, what will be the improvement over that system?
Sir, Industry 4.0 employs or try to have an integration of the cyber-physical systems with the various technologies like AI, machine learning, Internet of Things, and various other technologies as well. And it also will lead to the automation, in my opinion. And we have seen the robots like Sophia. So it have a good amount of intelligence if we compare it to the humans as well. And it is also gradually improving. So with that aspect, sir, eventually, sir, will lead to a kind of industry or an environment where robots will play a very important role in our society, sir.
Okay, then on that basis, what is your logical guess about what Industry 5.0 will hold?
Sir, I'd like to think for it, sir. Sir, my guess would be, sir, something related with robots and printing. So some people are saying that there would be next printing like 4D and 5D printing. So that can be involved in that, sir. However, sir, I'm not exactly sure.
Okay. You are fond of traveling, Jayant. Even yes. anthropology was your optional. You are yes. aware about Northeast tribes as well.
Yes.
Then why Northeast is your last option in cadre preference?
Sir, that was the preference, sir, if given to me. And I would be more than happy to serve, especially in the northeastern states, if given a chance as well, and to learn about various tribes as well. Sir, however, sir, if UPSC, sir, have asked me to give a preference, so that was purely on the basis of the preference, sir.
That's what I'm asking. Why Northeast comes at the last position in your order of preference? What is the reason?
Yes, sir. Sir, as I said, I like to learn about tribes as well. And sir, various states like Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, they also have a tribal population of around 13%. So, sir, it is not purely based on the liking of the tribes or that sort of. The primary reason of putting my preference was on the basis of the geographical proximity. So that's why I put my home state, and also I know more of the issues of my state. So I would be in a better position to administer and serve in those areas. So on that aspect, sir, I have given my preference.
Okay. Jayant, tennis is not that much of a team game compared to football or volleyball or even cricket.
Yes.
But still, tell me, what leadership lessons you learn from tennis?
Yes, sir. Sir, there were several personal instances, sir, when I learned a very good amount of lessons, especially from the tennis. So the primary one was, sir, don't lose calm even when you are a losing side, and just rather focus on making a strategy so that you can win the next point. And it is also highly applicable in leadership as well. Don't lose calm, and rather than be composed in order to tackle any problem. Secondly, sir, the kind of motivation that tennis employs, and the thing called perseverance, that given amount of any situation that you are in, you will come out strong, and that is highly applicable in leadership as well. And thirdly, sir, would be lead from example or the lead from front. So we also had team matches in tennis as well, and in that matches we used to compete various teams like IIT Delhi or BITS Goa as well. So in that, sir, we learned a kind of teamwork as well. So that is also applicable in leadership, sir. So these are the lessons.
Good. Jayant, you were a part of Hindi Press Club in your college,
yes.
right?
Yes.
What is your take on making Hindi a national language, as it is the largest spoken language currently in India.
Yes. Sir, Hindi is spoken by around 44% of our population. However, sir, in that 44% also, there are various dialects and various other forms of language that is used. Sir, for example, in Rajasthan also, people say that a good amount of population speaks Hindi. However, sir, there has been a local taste to it, like Marwadi. Marwadi of Bikaner is very different from the Marwadi of Jaipur. And sir, also the southern states, the use of Hindi is very less. Sir, in my opinion, sir, directly giving it a national language status would not be a prudent solution, because we have a majority of 56% that still do not speak Hindi. So rather than directly posing it as a national language, we should try to find certain ways in order to make it a link language that is also enshrined in our constitution, in order to ensure that we can promote the use of language, and it should be a voluntary method rather than forcing on the people.
So can I say that you are not in the favor of making Hindi a national language?
Sir, yes, I'm saying that the situation is not right now. However, sir, any decision should be taken into account by taking all the stakeholders that are there. So all the states should be taken into account, and then only, sir, a decision can be made.
Okay. So Jayant, I want to give you to give me just a yes or no answer. Are you in favor or you are in against?
Sir, at current time, sir, I'm not in the favor.
Okay. That's good. Jayant, what is your biggest weakness?
Yes, sir. Sir, I like to think of it. Sir, the first was the work-life balance, balancing my professional as well as public life. That sometimes lead to some of the issues on the health side as well. Secondly, sir, I also try to sometimes overthink on various situations that is not highly required. So these are some of the weaknesses, sir, I would say.
Okay. Thank you, Jayant.
Thank you, sir.
Jayant,
yes.
One final question before we let you go.
Yes.
Jayant, what is one thing that you hate? One thing that you hate to the core. You cannot stand that thing. What is it?
Sir, especially, sir, when I see people around me not wearing masks, and they are highly, even after getting one dose of vaccination, sir, they are so confident and roaming openly, defying the lockdown rules. So, sir, that I hate, sir, because there is some responsibilities of the citizens as well. And government also has some limitations. While in case of improving the COVID situation, it also becomes the responsibility and duty of we as a citizens to properly follow the COVID appropriate behavior. So that one thing, sir, I especially, sir, hate.
Thank you, Jayant. It was lovely interacting with you. We will reconnect with you in some time for your feedback. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Jayant, good things first.
Yes.
You spoke very well. Your communication skills are good. And some of the answers that you have given were very good. Your appearance is very decent, but it would be more appreciable if you have shaved.
Okay.
I think you missed the shave, and that can be with respect to lockdown or some other factor. But these are excuses, dear, right?
Yes. Yes.
Now, since Jayant, we are here to do a critical analysis, so that our ultimate aim is you improve on your flaws and you score very big on the D-Day. Clear?
Yes.
So, Jayant, first thing is that some of your answers were long than necessary. It means they were overstretched.
Yes.
Secondly, you did not listen to several questions properly. And the person who was asking you question had to again interject and said that maybe you did not understand the question properly. This was my question. It is a very desirable trait in a civil servant or a would-be civil servant, the learning capacity and the listening ability. Clear? See, Jayant, the whole idea of holding the interview or personality test is not to test your knowledge, but to check your personality. टू सी वेदर यू कैन बी ट्रेन्ड और नॉट. आप कहीं सिस्टम में मिसफिट तो नहीं हो जाएंगे घुसकर, ये देखा जा रहा है. ठीक है? एंड पीपल आर देयर टू सिलेक्ट यू, नॉट टू रिजेक्ट यू. बिकॉज इफ यू आर डूइंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ रिक्रूटमेंट, यू वुड लाइक टू गेट गुड पीपल क्विकली. क्लियर? जो इस तरीके के क्वेश्चंस होते हैं जैसे दिस वर्सेस दैट, जस्टिस वर्सेस इंटीग्रिटी, और हिंदी शुड इट बी मेड द नेशनल लैंग्वेज, देयर फर्स्ट यू शुड गिव एन आंसर इन यस और नो. लाइक इफ इट इज जस्टिस वर्सेस इंटीग्रिटी, इफ यू से नो बोथ आर इंपॉर्टेंट, आई वुड प्रिफर बोथ, डेफिनेटली देन दैट इज अ वेरी सेफ आंसर एंड एक्चुअली नॉट, यू कैन से फोकसिंग ऑन द की डिमांड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. Like suppose you are a district collector and you have limited funds, you can use the funds for health or education. You cannot say both health and education are important, then you will be nowhere with your policies. Yes. Right? So choose one and then try to qualify it with the second first. What you do is first you defend both and then you choose one when you are forced to do so. Like say for example, this Hindi question, a good answer would be that in the short run, no. In the long run, yes.
Yes.
Then your answer is diplomatic as well. Do you get that, dear?
Yes.
And so work on your the length of your answers. That's important. Yes. Your listening ability. Listen to the question very well. If you are not aware about the answer or if you are not aware about the terms used in the question, please ask for a clarification rather than jumping onto the answer. It would give a bad impression. Clear?
Yes.
And there was too much of head movement, Jan. The head was not stationary. It was like going like this and this. And I also saw that in between you took your gaze away from the screen. Maybe that was, you were looking at your phone or there is someone sitting around you. Maybe that was a factor.
The wire was loose, sir. I was concerned that.
Okay. So maybe that was a factor, but
yes,
it is not good, dear.
Yes. Yeah?
Especially when a question is asked to you.
Yes.
Because you were not doing that when you were speaking, but when you were listening. When you are listening to someone, you must look at that person, clear, very diligently and very carefully. Clear, Jan? Overall, I would say that age is on your side. Otherwise, you are a brilliant candidate, dear. And I see no reason why you will not get selected this way. Just work on these flaws. Clear? That was my feedback, Jan. If I would ask you to assess your performance, how would you assess?
Sir, it was
good, average, below average, or excellent?
Sir, I would say good, sir, because some of the questions, like you rightly mentioned, like justice and integrity, those could have been easily rightly tackled by. But
and one more thing, Jayan, is you must improve your knowledge with respect to World War II and tennis, specifically tennis. You were not aware about the height of the net properly, and you have played at the state levels. Clear? This is not expected from you. And hobby is something where you must have all the knowledge. You are not aware about DecoTurf. You are not aware about the Grand Slams properly. Then you are not aware about the color of the ball. What was the color of the ball previously? You must know how the game originated. It originated in France.
Yes.
So how, what is the meaning of the term tennis? You must know that as well. And World War II, especially when you answered that question, the name of the bombs, you said Fat Boy and Little Boy. And Little Boy is actually a name and the other name is Fat Man. And you were not sure about Fat Little Boy, but you said that I'm sure about Fat Boy.
Yes.
That was very bad, Jen.
Yes.
When you're not sure about something, you cannot hammer that point again and again.
Yes.
Jayant, otherwise, a very good performance, dear.
Jayant, your biggest advantage that you hold is your age. This is your first attempt. You have come into this the interview stage and the age is in your favor. I'm sure your curve is on the rise. Well, let me just give you my feedback. You seem to be well prepared for the interview. You were well dressed. But as pointed out, I felt you should have shaved. You're not looking as if you shaved. So that was a little bit of a dampener.
Yes.
Your answers were too long. 10th, two, three instances, your answers had to be cut short by the panelist.
Yes.
Even I have to cut short your answer because your answer started and it went on. Now, if remember, this is not a one day's interview, it is just a few minutes interview.
Yes.
You have to put your best point across immediately, because we are not here to listen to an introduction and then the content and then the conclusion.
Yes.
Right? You have to put your best point first and make it stand out. That is what has to be your basic aim. So don't go beating around the bush. So the answers should be reduced. The length of the answers has to be much, much lesser.
Yes.
Now, few questions you answered very well. I appreciate. But there were a lot of questions also wherein you said you were confident. When you answered, you felt you looked confident. But when you were questioned, are you sure? You said, no, I'm not very sure. At the point. And
yes.
Subsequently, whenever you were asked the question, are you sure? I felt as if you were getting stressed at that period of time. So answer the question only if you're very sure about it. If you are not very sure, don't fall into the trap, because it will add to your stress levels and your performance will slightly dip off to that.
Yes.
Now, as talked about the questions related to your hobbies and interests, World War II, you specifically said, so nobody asked you a question about World War I. Right? World War II questions, they were very, very basic questions. Very, very basic questions. Like the little boy, fat man, you combined them and made it to one simple thing, fat boy. So then even about the aircraft that was used, you knew it as B-29, right? Good. But what were they known as? What were they famously known as? Super fortresses. That is what you should have known. You know, basic things, because that is your interest area. So
yes.
Therein, we expect your much more knowledge about those particular things. Your communication skills were good, and I appreciate that. At times, when you talked about Federer and Nadal, you kept repeating Nadal 19-19. My dear friend, no, Nadal has won 20 also.
Yes.
Nadal and Federer are both at 20. Now you kept repeating. Second time I asked you the same question once again, thinking that probably a little time has passed. Maybe you may have rationalized in your mind, but you again said. So be very clear about it. If you are not sure, please do not answer as if you are absolutely right. It gives a very wrong message across.
Yes.
Couple of your answers were very good. I really appreciate. But as pointed out, this or that cannot be, you know, an answer which is talking about both the issues. You have to give your choice. You have been asked a specific question. What? This or that? Right? If I ask you water or food, you can't say water is important, but I think food is also important. I should know. If you ask a question, be very specific about what the answer should be. Right?
Yes.
That is where I think you felt. But otherwise, you were confident. And believe me, you have a very good and a very strong chance of making it in the civil services. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Jayant.
Yes, sir.
Jayant, good things first. You were confident throughout. Smile was missing on the first part of interview, but later part smile was visible. And the happiness answer, it was, I think, one of the best answer which I have heard about happiness. So keep that spirit in you. But as this is a critical analysis, some point of criticism. Number one, you were less aware about tennis, even World War II. And even the questions related to date of birth, your date of birth, you didn't answer them well.
Yes.
You have mentioned those things in your DAF, so we expect ki you should be better prepared for that. Okay.
Yes.
At some point, I felt that while answering, your answers were very long. And between them, you sounded a bit casual. You even used Hindi words. लाइक सर दिस इज द बट तो ऐसा होता है सो दैट तो वॉज विजिबल बिटवीन और इट वॉज आई हर्ड दैट आई डोंट नो वेदर यू स्पोकन इट और नॉट बट कंट्रोल योर वर्ड्स प्रॉपरली ओके डोंट यूज कैजुअल वर्ड्स इन बिटवीन द थर्ड पॉइंट योर हेड वॉज शेकिंग इवन वेन यू वर थिंकिंग योर हेड वॉज लाइक shaking too much so control your head movement okay
yes
and in case of historical answers if you think that you are going against or you are taking some extremist stand or it and it is because you read it somewhere as in case of Aurangzeb you could have said sir as per my limited knowledge or sir as per what I read in history books this is the scenario okay
Yes.
Then at many places you were beating around the bush. You were asked that choose between this or that. You it seemed as if ki you are answering a mains question. Mains mein jaise hum answer karte hain na, aap pehle puri wo background build karte hain and then you put forward your points. This is not the subjective examination. Ye aapka personality test hai. You should put forward your best point first.
Yes.
Okay. And if you are asked for yes or no. You should first say yes, but this is the qualification. You can qualify your answer, but at a later part.
Yes.
Okay. And when you were asked about your favorite leader.
Yes.
Because you will be asked or you may be asked about his weakness and you will fumble there.
Yes.
Okay. So choose some low level politician, your sarpanch or your local MLA. About which the board might not be aware. Okay, choose some local level politician or some international example such as New Zealand Prime Minister, which she is quite popular. So you can choose those example ke jinke bare mein koi negative comment ya weaknesses nahi puchi ja sakti. Choose local level politician or some international example. Okay.
Yes.
And even if I was not able to analyze your body language properly, but what I felt was that at some point you seemed to be stressed out. आपको भी शायद ऐसा फील हुआ कुछ कुछ पॉइंट्स पे आपका स्ट्रेस लेवल थोड़ा सा इंक्रीज हो जाता है और वो आपके फेस पे विजिबल था इट वुड बी मोर विजिबल वेन यू आर अपेयरिंग फॉर फिजिकल इंटरव्यू ऑनलाइन इंटरव्यू की लिमिटेशन होती है तो वो इतना विजिबल नहीं है बट फिजिकल इंटरव्यू में आप जब अपेयर करेंगे इट वुड बी विजिबल सो कंट्रोल ऑन दैट पार्ट
यस
Okay, otherwise your many answers were very beautiful. And especially as I mentioned, the happiness answer, your weakness answer. And one more thing I would like to highlight. You were asked a question by Roy sir about your mistake of your life.
Yes. Yes.
You do not build that background. Okay, sir, no, all mistakes happen for a good reason. I have learned from that. No. See, everyone makes a mistake and you should accept it. Yes, sir.
Yes.
This was my mistake, but I have worked on it and I would not repeat it in future. And I have learned from it that.
Yes.
As simple as that. Don't build the background. Okay. And keep your answer short and crisp as possible. It will do wonders. Mark my words. Okay, Jayant.
Thank you.
Jayant.
Yes.
If you have any specific questions, dear, you can ask them.
No questions
for myself. Okay. Jayant, एक बात बताइए आपको ऐसा लगा इंटरव्यू के दौरान कि कहीं पर आपने आंसर कर दिया है और फिर मिड आंसर में आपको रियलाइज हुआ कि आपका आंसर करेक्ट ट्रेजेक्टरी पर नहीं है
सर वो एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप वाला क्वेश्चन सर ओनरशिप सर
हाँ वो गड़बड़ था
उधर सब बैलेंस कर सकता
तो जब ऐसे आपको रियलाइज हो जाता है तो आप उस आंसर को वहीं पे शॉर्ट कर दीजिए और परमिशन लीजिए बोर्ड से सर कैन आई रीफ्रेज दिस आंसर विथ योर काइंड परमिशन
ओके
तो उनको ऐसा लगेगा कि हाँ कई बार हम बोल देते हैं कुछ बोलना है तो झट से हमारे मुंह से निकल गया लेकिन हमें रियलाइज जब हो गया उसके बाद भी हम उसे स्ट्रेच कर रहे हैं दैट इज नॉट गुड क्लियर जैन सो बेस्ड ऑन टूडेज परफॉर्मेंस जैन
Yes.
And this is not the judgment of your potential.
Yes.
But based on today's performance and considering all the pitfalls that we have noticed and the good points that we have noticed in your interview, the board is of the view that you will land up somewhere in the territory of 165 to 170. If your interview goes something like this, clear? But if you make these improvements, especially with respect to your hobby section, the date of birth, DAF related thing, मैं आपको एक तरीका बता रहा हूँ. आप अपना DAF लेकर बैठेंगे और हर वर्ड पे गूगल करेंगे, जैसे आपका डेट ऑफ बर्थ से लेकर आपका रोल नंबर तक. क्योंकि हो सकता है, समझ लो किसी का रोल नंबर 2611 आता है उसमें, तो 2611 से कोई क्वेश्चन हो सकता है.
Yes.
तो आप उससे कि आपके बर्थ डेट पे कौन से इंपॉर्टेंट सेलिब्रेशन है, कौन से इंपॉर्टेंट हिस्टोरिकल इवेंट्स हैं, कौन फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज हैं, उनके क्या व्यूज हैं, कोई फिलोसोफर निकल आया, समझ लो सोक्रेटिस निकल आया, तो उनके क्या व्यूज हैं, ये सब कुछ आपको पता होना चाहिए. सो डू दैट, वर्क ऑन योर लिसनिंग कैपेसिटी एंड कट शॉर्ट योर आंसर्स. डेफिनेटली यू विल क्रॉस 200.
थैंक यू सर.
क्लियर जैन?
यस.
थैंक यू एंड ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट. व्हेन इज योर इंटरव्यू शेड्यूल्ड जैन?
सर 23rd अगस्त.
ओके, सो यू हैव टाइम. वर्क ऑन योर फ्लॉज एंड यू विल डेफिनेटली लैंड अप ऑन द राइट साइड ऑफ द बॉर्डर.
थैंक यू सर. Thank you, everyone.